or what an architect does. Very nice. She said, with all of you here, that she said an architect designs things and places them in appropriate places. Very well answered.
Quite a few of them. We do
we basically think about how we make each structure and everything. But the question I want to ask you is, what makes them different? What is it about these different buildings that is different? Why is a hospital different from a school?
Shapes,
yes.
Sizes.
Length.
Floors.
The structure.
The length and the breadth. Absolutely, in school, students, hospital, patient. This is a very important point. The shape of the building itself, in terms of what size it is. Areas, designs, the shapes, rooms, yes. Square feet and things like that. The height, interior, roofs. The people who work there, another very important point. The number of rooms, yes. The things that are kept in. So we cover a few different things. One is obviously we are talking about different shapes, different sizes. We are talking about different heights and breadths and things like that for sure. We are also talking about what he mentioned about the school having students and a hospital having patients. Alright, I'll expand that a little more. I'm going to call that using, just like how she said, the people who use the space are different. Right? So, just like how people who go to a mall are shopping, right? Or the shopkeepers, right? People who go to a train station are the ones who are traveling somewhere. People who are in the school are studying. So all of us are doing different things in these buildings. That is one of the main things that makes these buildings different from each other. Yes? So the other things, like some of you mentioned, was the height of the building and things like that. That definitely, in terms of size. One question I'll ask you is, what makes them different and does your classroom look like your bedroom? Why not?
Yes.
Students? Yes, they all have students. There you go. There is no bed in the middle. In school, there are lots of tables and chairs and bedrooms around there. Blankets and all of that is out there. School furniture, yes. There are no fixed cupboards, absolutely. Then, actually, a school also has bathrooms like even. Tables are sharp in the classrooms and schools, it's not as sharp. Okay, one more person. One. No comfort. I think a school should also be comfortable, but I get your point. Bedroom is definitely more comfortable than a school. So a few of the things that we were talking about are definitely the different furniture. Right? Each place has a different type of furniture. If you go to an office, you have different furniture. If you go to a
hall furniture, you go to a restaurant, it will have different furniture, if you go to a classroom, it will have different furniture, and things like that. You go to a bedroom, it will have different furniture. Absolutely. Another thing that was mentioned as in the earlier point is the use of the place itself, what we use it for. So definitely. Another point is how many windows do you have in your bedroom? Does your classroom have more windows than your bedroom?
Yes!
Someone says no, very big bedroom. Mostly, generally, yeah, a place like this has a lot more windows. One of the reasons for that is the amount of light that we need in here. Because obviously we are reading books, but all of us are reading books and we are very far away and things like from the window itself. But we should still be able to read. As compared to a bedroom, we are going to sleep. We don't need as much light. Sometimes you study there, and so sometimes you need it to be slightly bright. Another thing is ventilation. Ventilation, does anyone know what ventilation means? Breathing, yes, absolutely. So the air that we breathe, more than 100 of us in this one room, right? And all of us are breathing air. And for that, and we're all going to start sweating and things like that if it gets so hot, which is why we have fans, right? But we have so many fans. And that's why we have so many open windows as well. That is what we mean by ventilation. There are quite a few other parameters that we as architects generally think about while designing. I'm not going to go into most of them, but there are a few of them if you want to read. We look at a lot of different parameters and things like that. The question is, how do we do this? Right? How do architects go about this? And use shapes to do everything that we just spoke about. That's the whole point. Right? Geometry is established as the basis of our art. Our art, we talk about architecture, and geometry is very, very critical to what we do. Right? And so now, what are the different shapes here? First and next one. Triangle, rectangle, square, circle, cuboid, pentagon, sphere. Two-dimensional shapes. A cube, a cylinder.
What? Any shape it can be.
It can be absolutely any shape. Absolutely. That's a very important one.
It can be any shape.
It's also described. You can make it any shape, yes. Hexagon. Arch. Very nice. Sorry. Cone, yes. Pentagon, yes. Okay, one last one. A polygon. It's all of the different polygons. Alright, so these are the different things that you probably studied about in your maths in terms of your geometry and things like that. And we'll be talking about a few of them just now. Alright, but yeah, most of you have heard of 3D. So we're going to be talking about it here. I'm hoping most of you can see the sketch. It's kind of a baddish kind of a sketch. But you've probably learned about this in maths, have you?
Yes!
Okay. So we're talking about the different shapes here that most of you have already mentioned. The 3D shapes, which are cubes and cuboids, spheres, cylinders, cones, pyramids, things like that. Your 2D shapes, which are your squares and rectangles, your triangles, pentagons, circles, all of those. And in your 1D, you also have lines and you have curves. Okay. What is 0D? Absolutely. Does 4D exist? No. I will stick with that answer for now. But when you're about 20 years old, you might have a start of this change in your thinking. But for now, yeah, it doesn't matter. Alright, so we'll just go through a few examples of all the different types of things that we spoke
about.
So the first thing we're talking about 1D and straight lines. The idea that I'm going to show here is mostly to show examples of where these things are used in real life, in architecture, in buildings, in design. Alright? A straight line, obviously the most obvious example is a road. This particular road is one of the longest straight roads on the planet. It is 256 kilometers, one straight line.
Nice.
And this is in Saudi Arabia, and the whole point of this was to get from one point to the other. Very, very good. Right? If you've ever gone on a in a car or a thing, you know that everywhere there are lots of curves and bends and things. Right? It takes a long road. But if your road was one straight road, sit in the car, put one brake on the accelerator or something, and then play chess with your friend. I don't. Right. So basically, with a straight road like this, the whole point was getting from point A to point B. What can we do more with a straight line? This is Rajpath in Delhi. Right. So Rajpath in Delhi, this road is again a very straight road. This is a little more important in terms of design and everything as it is used for the more important. I should probably you remember that first line that I said I might not know everything?
Thank you.
So, in Rajpath, I don't know all the buildings. The most important buildings are, yes, the India Gate, and that road is very, very important to our nation as a whole. That's where our Republic Day parades are, right? That's where our Independence Day parades are. That's basically that straight road leads straight up to the parliament, right? And so, in the capital of the nation. So it's a very important road to us. And because it's important, we made it very straight and made it ceremonial. We made it very wide. We didn't put any traffic there or anything. Such that the Republic Day parades could happen there and things like that. Similar ideas are, this is in Washington DC in America. This is again Beer Capital City. This is their capital building, just like how we have a column, this is their capital building. There you can see that tall tower there. So this is the Washington Monument, and little beyond that, there's a Lincoln Memorial as well. Alright, so basically on this one straight line, there is not even a road there. Right? It's like a garden. But that straight line still exists. That straight line to say that this is important. Then, how many of you, I think you've probably heard that a line is a series of points. Yes? So, this is, if you think of each one of these as a point, this is just a series of points. But it still feels like one straight line, no? So, this is called a colony, like a series of columns. Similarly, we can do the same thing with trees also. We can put trees in one line. Continuously, we can put one after the other. This is a building called the Salt Institute, and this is designed by a very famous architect called Louis Kahn. This straight line here has water running through, right in the middle of this place here. Because of the water, when the sun is setting, it almost glows, right? Because the sun reflects off this narrow channel of water, and because of that one straight line. Everyone who goes there takes this photo. They don't go that side and stand and take one photo like that. They always go straight, aligned. That is what Louis Kahn did. That's the architect. He made each and every
so symmetrical
person who goes there,
this side
and stand that one place and take that photo.
It's symmetrical also, no? See this side, that side.
This
both
is
sides
a house called the Farnsworth House. This is another very famous building, but if you notice, it's just a series of lines. It's just like two lines straight and a few lines vertical. That's it.
Bad lighting, yeah.
So that is a house. How many of you know of heard of the Apple phone, as in the iPhones and things like that? All
you've
heard of it. I thought to explain this point, but if this house wasn't built the way it was, in terms of the design, your Apple iPhone was look different today. That's the power of architecture. Is that confusing? Yes, it is. Am I going to explain it? No, I'm not. will be later. Okay, so the other thing, the next thing is the curved lens. So this is a curved road. Imagine driving on this road. What do you see? You want the best lines to go on. But the point is, this is a 1D thing as well. It's just curved. One continuous line is just another straight line. This is a river.
Or in a curve.
This is also, it's a very thin river, but it continuously curves. Right? That is also 1D. And this is a curve. So, this is a view of a university campus. All those lines that you see are different pathways. And those can be also one because ultimately whether it's a straight line or a curve, a pathway is just one line. So that's also one. Then another thing here is in terms of we were talking about the series of points making a line, like a series of trees or the columns. Similarly, in this thing, right, we have a series of those posts. That creates the curve, that creates the line. So similarly, as we did before, this is also another one of those curves. And moving on to 2D things, one is the simplest of examples and the simplest of the shapes are the triangle. Sorry? It's a normal shape, absolutely. Okay, but I should start there. The triangle is actually very, very important for us archaeologists. And then why I say this is, that's how we started. Right? The very first houses that anyone built were made of triangles. Right? It was just two sticks that you placed like this. Two sticks like that. And once you take that shape, you sleep under there. That was one of the first shelters that people made. Since then it's gotten a little more complicated and things, but we all started with just the triangles. Alright, so we architects really love the triangles. This is a Parthenon. So this is an ancient structure. This is close to 3,000 years old. But you notice that on top they have a triangle. And that is a very important feature of that period. And basically they thought that because the previous houses all look like triangles, here also they had to put a triangle. Right? It's as simple as that. And we're still doing that today. But this is what the actual structure looks like today. Okay, it's been broken down, it's in ruins and things like that. But this is in Athens, in the country, Greece. Okay, so if you ever get a chance to go see it. And then send me photos because I have this video. Can all of you see the number of triangles in this photo? So, triangles are used a lot in bridge construction. Basically, I try explaining it. If you don't understand, it's fine. It's okay, you can get this much later. But for now, assuming I had two supports, right? Assuming this was a table or something like that, and I had two supports and I kept on top. And on top of this, I put another straw or something like that. If I press it, there's a good chance that this entire thing will fall off that side. No, there's no stability there. So if you put another line here, if you put another straw there, it will not fall. It's a whole lot more stable. That's because of the triangles that you create. There are, how many of you play video games? All of you play video games. Have any of you by any chance heard the game called, which is Goo? G-O-O, the game of Goo by any chance? Or Bridge Builder? Any of these games? Bridge Builder? Do you use triangles in them? Yeah? Show that game to your friends. It's a lot of fun to play, but it's using this line here. Using making bridges like that out of are called trusses, right? And they are made to hold up the roof itself. And churches, yes, mostly in our area, churches have a lot of roofs. Now, we come to our favorite shape, squares. I will also put rectangles in here because, why not? this is a plaza. In British. So a plaza is basically this huge space in front of shops such that people can just walk out and sit down and talk to each other and things like that. Alright, so this is a plaza that is designed in Madrid. Madrid is in Spain. This is the Mughal Gardens. This is Rashtrapati Bhavan. Okay, this is our capital building, our Parliament House. These are the gardens of that, not the Parliament House, the residential house. You can see the number of squares. It's only, this entire thing is made of squares and more squares and squares placed on squares and cut and more squares and things like that. That's it. But this entire garden is made with those kind of ideas. This is the Madurai Meenakshi Temple. Has any of you been to a Madurai Meenakshi? Of course, you will be very nice. So, this temple, if you look at it from on top, you realize that it has huge, it has gopuram, you get to gopuram in some times. It has huge walls, alright? And it has them in many layers. And each one of them is either a square or a rectangle. Okay, you'll notice this in most temples, most of the Indian temples.
Great, it's down only in a
circle. Let's get to service. Oh no, sorry, one part. I think I missed this thing. This was supposed to be for the previous thing, which was going to be an example for the squares. So this is here, inside the tank, it's a small little tank, it's called a Kalyan. Alright, with the steps going in and things like that. Okay, so now we get to service. Our attention please. The reason I put this picture up is because this is one of the worst designs possible. All of us architects, all of us designers, so should they see this, feel bad. We feel like we should say sorry. Alright? How many of you heard of Maple Circle?
Yeah.
How many of you heard of Berry Circle? A few of you? Okay. In Maple Circle, there is a circle. It used to be there. Alright? Close to 10-15 years back, probably before you people were born, there used to be a full circle, something like this. In Maple Circle, way back then. Since then, we realized, okay, this is a bad idea. We're going to have more and more traffic, this is not going to solve anything. So we started. Exactly. This is, as you might know, a traffic circle. This is the Vatican. This is actually called St. Peter's Square. I don't know why it's called a square, there is no square, it's a circle. Alright, are you telling me that they brought him off this entire thing, this particular square? I don't know. I think it's named wrongly named, but it's nothing about my country. Anyway. So this is called there is a St. Peter's Basilica. You heard of that? That's a very, very, very famous church. That's where the Pope sits. Alright? This is a library. Designed by this person called Louis Kahn, right? Who's an architect. This is an aerial photo. It's not really a building, but it's full of farmland. This is just outside of Dubai. And one of the reasons they have circular farms, as in here we see all our, as in if you go outskirts of Bangalore and things, you'll see all the things being grown in rectangular kind of shape. So here it's circular, because of how far the water will reach, right? So in the center they have effectively like a sprinkler system, and so as it spins, so effectively If you notice, right at the center of each one of these points is where the water is going to come from. Right? And it starts to spray, but it obviously goes around in a circle. And so that's what the shape of the farm is like. Got it? Now, this is, I should be honest. I don't even show this to, I teach architecture college, right? I just mentioned. I don't even show this to first year architectures. I show this to my third or fourth year architectures.
Okay.
So this is going to be complex. Right? It might take a little more concentration, but pay attention. Tessellation is the word. Right? It's a complicated word, but basically what it means is tiling. Right? Tiles. If you look at your room itself, each one of these tiles is a square. Right? And you have squares next to each other. And placing them next to each other is called tiling or tessellation. But obviously, squares are boring. We go to a little more complicated shapes. Okay. Now, you recognize a few shapes. You recognize a few shapes in here. This is what shape? Hexagons. What shape is this? Square. So with hexagons and squares, they've created this shape. It's only hexagons and squares, there's no shape. Right? So if they had a tile which was square and they had a tile which was hexagon shape, they could create that shape. That makes sense? Yeah? Similarly, let's look at this one. This is a bunch of stars with again a hexagon. Right? These are a lot more complicated. These are again hexagons with triangles and so on. Hold on. This is jali work. Does anyone know what jali is? A net, exactly. Alright, jali, like in your Hindi Urdu kind of jali, is a net. So jali work is basically this kind of stone work. This is stone made for a window. Alright. So a lot of these kind of things are you can see them all over the place, especially in the older temples. If you visit them and things like that, please stay home. Especially in North India, a lot of this happens in North India. Now, this is where it gets really complicated. So, this is thinking tessellation. This is a mosque. Right? This is a mosque in Iran, in the country of Iran. This each one of those things, each one of the different colors that you see all over here, each one of them is a separate type. It's a separate type that is stuck to that shape and then placed exactly. These are each one of the types. Is a different color, is a different type, which has been painstakingly cut by one person and then got placed there by another person. So imagine the number of people who worked on this and how long it would have taken and the amount of careful work. Iran, in the country of Iran. Okay, now let's get back to our regulation program. Let's come back to our this is an aquatic center. This was built for the 2008 Olympics, the Olympic Games. So if you see on top here, you'll see this is the interiors of the place. So there are swimming pools inside and the entire thing is actually transparent. Right? This entire thing where you see blue is because the lights inside are blue. It's not just the water, it's lit as blue. So basically, this is
built in China.
This is a very important building architecturally. Look at those apartment buildings, you know.
Only in the center part is open.
This building was one of the first apartments ever built. One of the first where we got the idea for apartments. How to build apartments. This is one of the first types of those buildings. This is a building in France, designed by this very famous architect called deem. We actually learn about this guy in college. Right? There are textbooks written about these buildings and things. It's a very, very. These are actually. These things here, these are tall. These are just like your pillars, but much, much, much bigger. Huge tall. Huge pillars. That's the point. You can design. That's part of what we learn. How to make things like this. It's made out of concrete. This is designed by this lady architect called Sound. This was designed in 1967. So this is a very old building. And again, one of the first as in buildings like this didn't exist, obviously, even now it surprises you. Imagine 15 years ago when it was solid building. But yeah, this thing. Is Bangalore. Have any of you seen this building? Right? A few of you. Next time you're going towards MG Road, when you're going past the General Post Office, the GPO, this is the building on the other side. Okay, you'll see this down there and stuff. It's a quite a tall building. This is designed by an architect called Charles Collier, an Indian architect. He's done a lot of work. He was actually head of the BDA and things like that for a while. But yes, cubes is what you can do with cubes. Now, pyramids. Obviously, all of you know what a pyramid is. All of you have seen the Egyptian pyramids. The pyramid at in Mexico are very, very old, right? And these are very, very far away from each other, literally from the other side of the planet, right? So the question was, how did all of them descend from the same shape? Right? They are so far away, they never spoke to each other, but they still do this. The simple answer is, if you have rocks, you put them in a pipe, it's going to last. Right? What I mean by that is, most of the other buildings around it, all your houses and whatever else they had, just fell down. It became old and fell down. When a pyramid falls down, it stays the same shape. Because there's no place for it to fall. It's already falling down. That's why the pyramids have lasted for so long. It's just a bunch of rocks placed one above the other. And done very precisely, of course, has to be done geometrically correctly. But ultimately, they are self-supported. They have not going to fall down. Even if there's an earthquake or something like that, these things are not going to fall down. Because they already kind of falling down. Absolutely. This took a very, very long time and slave labor. Yes, it took a lot of people to build this thing. So this is in Mexico. So let's move to cylinders and cones. Can any of you count the number of cylinders and cones? Okay, stop it. I'm not going to do that because I haven't counted. I don't know the correct answer. Even if you guess, I won't. Okay, I'm just joking. But yes, if all of you watch Harry Potter, and you'll see the number of cylinders. Possibly, who knows, you're not. Okay, so there are lots of cones two sample rooms and cylinders which are the towers and cells and stuff like that. Can anyone know which is different on tower here? Okay, these are industrial structures. These are called silos. You see, these industrial structures are called silos. Basically, silos are huge storage caves. Alright, so inside this, there's probably either rice or wheat or something like that. Huge quantities of. And you'll notice that the bottom has like a funnel. All of you know what a funnel is, right? It's here. That's basically a funnel. It's a much, much, much bigger funnel. So we call it a hopper, but ultimately it's just a funnel. These are water towers. Water towers made out of brick, again with cylinders. There's one with a cylinder and a cube in between there. And let's move to spheres. This is something called entering in Brussels. You can actually enter each one of these spheres and go there. So next time you're going on a Europe trip, go there. No, you don't have to walk through the poles. There are generally staircases and stuff like that. You see this? So you can climb through there. These are not prospects. These are actually very. So these are shiny. Okay, so it's like a very, very shiny glow. So it's actually reflecting the. That's why it looks so. Yes, absolutely. Little while later, maybe either next year or year after that, you'll be learning in your physics and science about atoms and things, but you'll be learning about the shapes. Now, what do you learn? You learn about the shapes of the brick. This is meant to define your form. Right? It's meant to look like an atom. This is. John Footson is an architect. Each one of these things is, if you take a sphere, you take a ball and you chop it, you can cut it up, then you can place it like this. Alright, so basically what he did was took a sphere, chopped it up and made it into this. Alright, so that's what the same formula for food. This is so this is your attention. This is in a place called Oribil, which is next to Pondicherry, in Tamil Nadu, India. Oh, by the way, each one of these things that look like gold is actually gold. And the way they've done it is very interesting. They literally put gold between two sheets of glass. Alright, they took two sheets of glass, put one thin layer of gold and put the sheets of glass together. And then arranged it in this kind of a shape. So go check it out, Spotify. This is Bulanda Plaza. But again, you can notice all the spheres in these things, we call them domes. So basically on top of all these we have the domes. Now, we come to something that you might not have done so far in your school. There aren't so many of the slides left. But in terms of the these things you might not have done before, this is basically arranging different shapes together. Alright? And some of the examples of these are things like this. This is the place for Bakipur Sikri. This is in Agra. You'll notice that this is a cue point, that's a separate cue point, that's another cue point, there's a sphere on top, so many different shapes. Right? And you arrange all these different shapes next to each other. That's the thing. This is a building in Bhopal. It's a much more recent structure, but again, you can notice all the different shapes. First of all, there's a cylinder kind of, a very short cylinder with a circle. And then you have like homes and homes and all sorts. Building that anyone ever heard. It's made of concrete. I want to tell you something about this. This one is again a composition of shape. It's not just a cube, it's not just a sphere. It's one of the wonders of the world. The marble is not, it's very much. This thing, in terms of composition, I want to talk about. Can you see all the different shapes? There's a huge cuboid at the bottom. There are these four cylindrical things. There are there's this entire structure. There's so many domes around it, and all of these. Right? The point is, the composition was done so precisely. The designing was done so precisely that you don't even realize how big this thing is. You realize that these things here. That's the size of a person.
What is that, sir?
That's the point. This much. It's something like a 3-4 story building. It's about how big like, this building is. That's a little more than that. We'll be here. This is this big. Alright? But they sat and figured out how big, how what size each thing has to be. And that is what they came up with. It looked perfect. It looked perfectly proportioned. It is very symmetrical. Oh yes. That's the point I wanted to mention that I completely forgot. But yes, symmetry is a very important part of this building. Please. Yes. Yes. It doesn't fall on top of it and things like that. You can actually notice that it already here at the point that she just made, where the pillars are slightly slanting outwards and stuff. One of the reasons is while it is here, right? If it was straight, it would actually look like here. And in terms of the composition of it, it looked off. Alright, as in if someone was to paint it, it looked like it was slightly tilting or something like that. And so they stood very far away and exactly figured out what angle it should be and made it that. So it's not exactly straight, it's slightly but that is one of the reasons it is the seventh wonder of the world, because the proportions and everything are designed so beautifully that even after we see it for so long, we don't realize how big it is. That's the same thing. Okay, moving on. I'll talk about something called transformations, which are basically changing the shape of something. Okay, something like this, where you have two cuboids, you keep the two cuboids on top of each other, and then you push this side down, alright, so it kind of tilts. And then you take a knife and you chop, right, so you get this shape. And then this yellow thing is meant to be a parking lot. Okay? So how many of you have seen a ramp or a parking lot in a mall? Yeah, and then you go up. That is what this is. Right? So you can see that. So that's a ramp with all the cars parking. So that is here. On top of that, you put the same thing there and you chop it up. That's the building. Alright? So this is another way that architecture is done. You change the shapes of things. Like this. It's a very simple thing. It's like a twisting thing. Right? Then, I will end with this set of pictures, the last three pictures of the slide. But I'm hoping this will blow your mind. This is where architecture is going now. This is what we're in the most famous buildings of the present time, built in the past 10 to 20 years. This is what they look like. This is by a lady called Zaha Hadid. This is in a place called Baku. This is a factory. I don't know. But yeah, that's the point. That's what architects can do. We can do things like this and still make it work like a factory. This is designed by the same lady, Zaha. This is this is designed by a person called Frank O'Gary. This is a Guggenheim museum in Bilbao. This is Spain. And there's a spider also. Basically, this is a museum. Alright, so inside it has lots of art. This is a one of another artist named installed. Right, so the person designed it and then. And so yes, with that, I think that's the end. There is one. So with that, I think I'll conclude. Thank you for listening and being all excited about it. Thank you for wishing me to be here.